Well, supposing I've got a monitor set up with the color bars, and now what do I do? Well, there's basically four things that you can set: brightness, contrast, hue, sometimes called phase, or color, sometimes called chroma. So let's have a look at the four things one at a time and see how they interact. And how do you set this up by eye without any fancy equipment? Well, brightness, let's start with the most obvious one. Brightness, you don't want it too bright or too dark. I mean, clearly, that's too dark, and clearly, that's a little on the bright side. It's just too crazy, and plus all this gray stuff starting to show up in the corner. So bring back down your brightness control so it's somewhere in the middle, so it looks right to you. Now, when setting up brightness, there's a special part of the color bar signal you should use. And it's this piece down the corner. It's called PLUGE, and it stands for Picture, Lineup, Generating Equipment. And here's how it works. It consists of three parts: an area that's darker than black, an area that's whiter than black, and it's separated by areas that are of a neutral black in between. And here's how it works. What you want to see ideally is you want the regular black section and the darker than black section to merge together. They just become one tone of black. But you should still be able to see this little lighter than dark, lighter than perfect black section in here. So adjust the brightness accordingly. If the brightness is up too high, you get to see everything, and that's not what you want to do at all. So you slowly take down the brightness until it's set up just right, and you can see that these bars over here merge together, but the lighter bar is still visible on the screen. That's the perfect setup. Now there's two factors to consider. Number one is, this will vary depending on what the ambient light is like in the room. So the monitor won't look right in certain lighting settings, and it'll look right in other lighting settings. Additionally, it depends how far away you are from the monitor when you look at it. If you're close up, you'll find that you want that brightness setting set differently than if you're sitting some distance away from the monitor. So that's a factor in this as well. Contrast is the same idea. Contrast too high, the colors will just almost have a hard edge to them. Too little contrast, well, there's not really enough contrast in the picture, is there? Everything's a little bit too dim and too dark. So again, adjust your contrast so it actually feels right to you. The other two, hue and color, are ones that you can work with a little bit more closely. Let's take color next. Color, or saturation, is set up basically the same way. If there's too much color in the shot, if it's oversaturated, things are going to be ringing with color. They're just going to be electric and neon. That's going to be too much. Well, obviously, if you go the other way, it means that there's no color in the picture at all. Of course, that's not right. So you bring it up. You want colors to be saturated, fairly fully detailed saturated. And color bars are very saturated colors. So you want to bring the colors up, and so they're quite rich and bold. If they look that way with color bars, your regular program material will probably look right as well. Finally, there's hue, or phase. And hue, this one you can do fairly easily by eye. You can see here, this is sort of a lemon yellow color bar. It's a nice bright yellow, and then this is sort of cyan. Well, that's a solid green. That's sort of a purpley color. Ooh, that's a sharp red. That's a nice deep blue. And if I change the hue, you'll see those colors change dramatically. If I turn it too far in the one direction, you see all sorts of things. Suddenly this yellow bar becomes very orange. These two are green almost together, and that's just simply not right. And this one's turned pink all of a sudden. So if I go too far the other way, I'll go back through the center position and go in the other direction to the other side. The yellow bar is suddenly turning green. Well, green's certainly looking fine, but this one's almost like too much almost pinky. It shouldn't be like that at all. And this one's way too blue. So I'll back it off and put it in the middle, and you'll find when it's set up just about right, there we go. This one's a nice bright pink color. That's a nice sharp red, blue, green. Cyan is a nice sky blue, yellow, and this color on the left is actually a gray tone, so it shouldn't have any color in it at all. In black and white, you can do the same thing. Now, you don't have the color and the hue to worry about, but you've got brightness and contrast, so you can do the same tricks with that. Brightness and contrast you set up the same way as you would on a color monitor, and pay attention to that pluge in the corner, that picture lineup generating equipment. Again, you adjust the brightness so you can just see the upper gray bar, but the lower gray bar actually disappears.